A very good morning to all. Looking at important headlines from the Hindu newspaper for 12th September, on the front page you have "Sit down and talk. UN Chief Guterres tells India and Pakistan." So this is UN Secretary General Antonio Guterres, who remains concerned about any escalation in tensions between India and Pakistan over the Kashmir issue, and he has appealed to both sides to deal with it through dialogue. Then this is regarding TDP political development. The TDP president N. Chidambaram Naidu and his son were placed under preventive detention at their residence because they were about to launch Chalo Atmakuru to protest attacks on party workers. On page 3 you have stolen Nataraj idol on the way back to Tamil Nadu after 37 years. So Australian authorities have handed it over to officers and it will be brought back to India now. So this Nataraj idol was stolen 37 years ago from a temple in Kallidai Kurichi in Trinuvelli in Tamil Nadu. So it was smuggled out and now it will be brought back. So this is a Nataraj idol and you should know about it. The entire cultural aspect of it, like the flames around this ring, you can see the demon at the near the feet, and the other postures as well as what's held in the hand, because such questions on culture are asked. And this is a standard Nataraj idol, so you should know about it. It's a 16th century bronze idol. And then on page 9 you have families outside submergence zone of Narmada Dam to be identified. So now there is a need for rehabilitation, and Medha Patkar, the social activist here, has demanded that immediate relief should be extended to those who have been shifted. And this is gifts given to Prime Minister to be auctioned. So this is regarding gifts which Prime Minister Narendra Modi has got from political leaders, religious groups and business leaders in the past 6 months. They would be about 2,772 such gifts that would be put under the hammer and auctioned starting September 14. So earlier too, such e-auction has been done by Prime Minister Modi, and now this is the second one which would be done. Then this is center to bring ordinance to ban e-cigarettes in country. So tobacco industry questions the move and calls it draconian, but central government is keen on an ordinance to ban e-cigarettes. On the editorial page, the first editorial is lynching, not murder. So this is regarding Tabrez Ansari case. It was covered in news yesterday. So it says suspicion that the Ansari case is being diluted underscores need for anti-lynching law. That is a demand, but the government has decided to call it murder, the central government. Some states have passed anti-lynching laws. Then this is Brexit brinkmanship. So this is regarding UK, the Prime Minister Boris Johnson. He's firm on leaving by October 31, but a last minute breakthrough looks remote. So EU should agree to what Britain demands. So there should be a divorce deal which should be finalized between the two. Only then Brexit can take place on October 31. Otherwise, the law passed by British Parliament says an extension should be sought for 3 months. There should be no deal Brexit. Then the lead article is the absentee constitutional court. So this is regarding how, unlike in 1976, the judiciary has not upheld the suspension of civil rights. Instead, it has ducked, evaded and adjourned. So this is regarding for suspension of civil rights as such have taken place in recent times. Similar scenario was also there in 1976 during Indira Gandhi's tenure during emergency. At that time, the judiciary had upheld suspension of civil rights. This time judiciary has not upheld suspension of civil rights, but at the same time it has used evasion, like it's avoiding, duck, evade and adjourned as such. So like in Jammu and Kashmir too, it said it would hear the case later, giving time to the government, giving time for normalization of the situation, and in many such scenarios. So that's covered here. And this is striking a blow for investigative credibility. So this is regarding investigating agencies. It says that the investigating agency should be given more freedom to be professional without diluting the controls already in place. Then on op-ed page you have a case for a differential global carbon tax. So this says all nations must climb down the emission ladder without giving up on their standard of living. So climate change is a global problem and there's a need for a global solution. Even IPCC report, Intergovernmental Panel on Climate Change report suggests that as humankind, we must look at how we can reduce global emissions. Total emissions have to fall by 45% from 2010 levels by 2030 and should reach net zero by 2050. And it says if these targets are not met, tropical regions of the world, which are densely populated and are concentrated in global in the global south as such too, are likely to be most negatively affected. So this shows the relationship between level of income and emissions at the global level. So maximum emissions are by high income group. So here you can see what is being demanded is a global carbon tax. So it's called a Robin Hood tax in terms that this should compensate countries like India, other developing countries, which are majorly affected because of these emissions. So take from the rich and give to the poor. That's Robin Hood. Then this is a narrow nationalism again. So this is regarding NRC exercise. It says the positions held by some intellectuals on the NRC only further legitimize a rapid dissension into regional exclusivism. It's covered here. Then this is also regarding the transfer. It says indefensible transfer that needs to be reversed. So it says the collegium's move dents the judiciary's image. So this is in the context of transfer of the order of transfer of Madras High Court Chief Justice V.K. Tahilaramani to the Meghalaya High Court, which he did not accept and rather preferred to resign rather than be transferred. So holding a post at Madras High Court, it's of course considered as a demotion. On page 12, you have two anti-lynching bills being examined by center. So state governments have passed two bills. Since they are amending the CRPC, they need approval of the central government. So these are bills from Rajasthan and West Bengal Legislative Assembly. They have been passed in August 2019. So they will be looked into by the center. Then there's no important news in the sense there are continuation of news. This is regarding Brexit, then which we have been discussing almost every day. We don't need to cover every viewpoint. Then this is regarding Afghanistan after the talks collapsed between Taliban and USA. So fighting has intensified, which was obvious. And this is regarding NSA being removed. That also we have covered yesterday. So that is there. So there's nothing important on international page today. On business page, you have tax authorities to file special appeal even for small cases. So income tax department has now decided to detect evasions specifically designed to fall below threshold for appeals. So this is a decision taken last month. So it will increase the monetary limit for cases below which it could not appeal the court's decision. So this has backfired because now a lot of organized tax evasions are taking place. Because government cannot appeal all cases, it is time consuming. So there is a threshold, monetary threshold. So the floor for filing appeals in income tax appellate tribunal has been increased from 20 lakh to 50 lakh. So, and the limit for appealing against high court order was increased from 1 crore to 1 crore from 50 lakh. So this increase means if it is less than that, then there will be no appeal. In Supreme Court order, for Supreme Court appealing to a Supreme Court order, the threshold limit was increased from 1 crore to 2 crores. So this increase in threshold limits have seen that cases are designed in such a way that evasions are of that extent, so that appeals, if the decision of the court is in favor of the tax or tax evader, alleged tax evader, then income tax department will not appeal that case. So now the government wants to change its policy, says even for small cases, special appeals can be filed. Then on the last page you have, Russia scraps robo after Odyssey. So this is Fedor, which is the Russian robo, which was blasted off to International Space Station. But now the developers have admitted he could not replace astronauts on spacewalk. and they said he won't fly there anymore. There's nothing more for him to do there. He's completed his mission. This is Fedor, the humanoid robo being tested as such. So that is it. These are the important headlines. For detailed coverage of current affairs, you can visit our website, asia.com. Thank you.